occasionally.
Of course, I've seen you in the newspaper. You're out of water.
I'm a journalist. Be patient, Snowy. Not much longer.
Something of your likeness.
Not bad. What do you think, Snowy?
Snowy.
There you are, sir. Why has he run off so much?
Anything?
Nothing. Snowy! Double decks, 50 guns. Oh, isn't she a beauty?
That's a very unique specimen, that is, from an old sea captain's estate.
The Unicorn.
Unicorn, man of war sailing ship. It's very old, that is. 16th century.
17th, I think.
Reign of Charles I.
Charles II.
That's what I said, Charles II. As fine a ship as ever sailed the seven seas. You won't find another one of these, mate. And it's only £2.
I'll give you a pound.
Done.
Gently does it.
There you go. Careful.
Hey, bud. How much for the boat?
Oh, I'm sorry. I just sold it to this young kid.
Oh, yeah? Tell me what you paid, and I'll give you double.
Double?
Thanks. But it's not for sale.
Look, kid. I'm trying to help you out. And I don't think you realize this, but you're about to walk into a whole mess of danger.
What kind of danger?
I'm warning you. Get rid of the boat and get out where you still can. These people do not play nice.
Oh, people.
Wonderful. Oh, it's just wonderful. Don't bother wrapping it. I'll take it as is. Does anybody object if I pay by check?
If you want to buy it, you'll have to talk to the kid.
I see. Well, the kid name his price.
Name his price? Oh, 10 years I've been flogging bric-a-brac and I've just named the price by one bleating minute.
I'm sorry. I already explained to the other gentleman.
American he was. All hair oil and no socks.
It's not for sale.
Then let me appeal to your better nature. I have recently acquired Marlin Spike Hall, and this ship, as I'm sure you're aware, was once part of the estate
of the late sea captain.
The family fell upon hard times. Lost everything. They've been living in a cloud of bad luck ever since. We are talking generations of drinking and irrational behavior.
I'm sorry, but as I told you before, it's not for sale. Good day to you, sir.
That young man, what's his name?
Him? Everybody knows him. That's Tintin.
Where is that man? Oh my God. Thank you.
We're going to the one place that could have the answer. Come on, Snowy.
This is Haddock of Marlin Spike Hall, the last captain of the ill-fated Unicorn. The ship set sail from Barbados in 1676 on one of the most ruinous voyages in maritime history. The ship never reached destination, attacked by pirates, all hands lost except for one survivor. When Sir Francis was rescued and returned home, he was convinced his name had been cursed. The Unicorn's manifest stated that it was carrying a cargo of rum and tobacco bound for Europe, but it was long claimed the ship was carrying a secret cargo. What was the ship carrying, sir? Historians have tried and failed to discover what happened on that fatal voyage. But Sir Francis's last words, only a true Haddock will discover the secret of the Unicorn.
Snowy, we need to take a closer look at that model. attacked by a wolf.
I see you let yourself in.
I came to retrieve my property.
I'm sorry, I'm not sure I thought.
There's no legend.
Oh, I think you do. This ship was stolen from my apartment less than an hour ago.
I'm afraid you're mistaken, Mr. Tinker.
There's no mistake. It belongs to me.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. I took it home. I put it on the cabinet in the living room, and then Snowy chased the cat and knocked it over, and it fell. This isn't my ship.
No, indeed.
Sorry. Looks identical.
Well, looks can be deceiving.
Yes, indeed. I don't understand. Why did Sir Francis make two ships exactly alike? And you have one already. Why do you want another? What is it about this model that caused someone to steal it?
Goodness me! Why so many questions?
It's my job. There could be a story. That's what I do, you see.
It's no great mystery. Sir Francis Haddock was a drunkard and a hopeless reprobate. He was doomed to fail, and he bequeathed that failure to his sons.
So it's true. The Haddock line is cursed.
What else have you found out?
What is there to find?
That depends what you're looking for.
I'm looking for answers, Mr. Zachary.
You're looking in the wrong place. It's late. I think you should go home.
This way, sir.
It's a pity, sir.
Sorry?
That the mast broke on your model ship, sir. I hope you found all the
pieces. It's just a sign.
It's just everything lost. Good night, sir.
Something's obviously lost. What did he mean by that, sir? What was he trying to tell me? Something's so easily lost.
You love your Sandy Weibo.
Great snakes! What is it, Snowy?
There's someone special in your life, Rango.
After bedtime, I have to go back to my cocoa. I've got a very good book and a cup of cocoa. It's really lovely.
Thank you, Mrs. Finch. I can.